Ah, I grew up in a place such as this. They say you can never go home again, but for 10 silvers an hour, you can get pretty close.
Isabella,
that scamp Carlone sent you, right?
I think you forget who you are speaking to. Us. I will give you a chance to leave quietly.
If you're here,
he's brazen hustle. Someone needs to put you in your place.
Be off with you now, and be glad I only took from you your gold. Fools. And look who we have here. Come to apologize for leaving me bereft of my lord husband and then vanishing without a trace.
You know it was just business, Isabella. Business that turned out well for you, I see. You inherited the ship, I take it.
I suppose I never did like the greasy bastard, and the siren treats me far better than she ever did him. Any catching up Zevran and I have to do, we wouldn't be doing out here in the market. Now, Zev, shouldn't you introduce us?
Indeed. This is Isabela, queen of the Eastern Seas and the sharpest blade in Lomeren. And Isabella, my dear, you will no doubt be amused to discover that I am traveling with a Grey Warden.
A Grey Warden? Charmed. I assume you saw that little drama, and none of these poor brutes has ever proven a match for me. They are too clumsy and predictable. I fight with quickness and wit, rather than with brute force and strength. I call myself a duelist because I honed my skills in duels with warriors I encountered over the years. As I said, it is better to avoid being hit, and it is best not to get into fights at all. An unusual request, coming from a fearsome slayer of darkspawn. I am flattered that you wish to learn from me, boasted sister. It will take you years of practice to achieve true mastery of the style, but I can teach you the basics. I do, however, wish to get to know my potential student better, so we shall call for a drink, and you will honor me with a game. Do you have something else in mind? Oh, and now you've piqued my interest. It would surely be rude of me to decline such a delicious offer. And what about you, Zev? Shall we? For old time's sake?
Oh, Isabella, you and your ridiculous appetites. Perhaps we should leave it up to our friend here.
Ah, this brings back memories. Come, my ship is down by the docks, and I am sure you will find my cabins quite comfortable. Well, that brings back memories, doesn't it, Zev? Pleasant ones, even.
For you, maybe. I still remember the time your husband tried to kill me. I had to flee across the rooftops completely unclothed.
Ah, yes. Those pleasant memories. Now, wasn't there something you wanted from me? A lesson, perhaps? Come, we will need some space for this.
Yes? What are you doing here? Brother Genitivi? Why? His research? Ah, you mean his search for Andraste's ashes. He was on the trail of the Urn of Sacred Ashes, yes. Whether he found it, the Maker only knows. I haven't seen Brother Genitivi in weeks. He sent no word. It's so unlike him. I'm afraid something has happened. Genitivi's research into the Urn may have led him into danger. I don't know. He was very excited when he left and said he would be back with all the answers. Perhaps the urn has been lost for a reason. I pray for Genitivi's safety, but hope dwindles with each passing day. I tried to send help, but some knights came from Redcliffe looking for him not long ago. I sent them after Genitivi, and they too have disappeared. Now don't ask me where they went. You'll go after them. And what if ill luck should befall you too? This search is a curse on all of us. Some things are not meant to be found. I know that now. So be it. All he said before he left was that he would be staying at an inn near Lake Callenhard, investigating something in that area. Good luck. May you find the answers you seek.
I thought it was all over. No, I thought I was. I will explain everything when we are back at camp. Now is not the time.
Good day, and welcome to the Spoiled Princess. Is there something I can get for you? Brother Jin... No, of course not. I've never heard of him. No, I haven't seen any knights. Why would I be nervous?
Listen, the person you're looking for isn't here. You should be on your way as soon as possible. They're watching me. I can't speak openly. Don't look around and keep your voice down. They're looking for anyone asking for this brother Genitivi. They told me to act like nothing's wrong and just deny ever having seen the brother or the knights. I don't know. You should be on your guard and leave quickly. I don't know what happened to the knights, but I doubt it was anything good.
Goodbye, and make her turn his gaze on you.
Glad you are alive, of course. If you live, then my fellows have failed. I can see their deaths in your eyes. I knew them well. My brothers died in the service of Andraste. May she draw their souls to her and cast yours into oblivion. For Andraste!
Of course. All right. Of course.
I think I owe you an explanation for what happened earlier. You should know that something happened to me at the tower before you came along. Remember my apprentice, Petra? She encountered a demon in the tower. It would have killed her had I not intervened. I saved her life that day, but I did not survive that encounter with the demon. It's not a joke, I promise. Let me explain. I engaged a very powerful demon to rescue Petra. It sapped me of all my energy and will and left me drained. It took everything I had to defeat it. And when I was done, I no longer had the strength to keep my heart beating. I remember my life ebbing away. Everything receded from me. Sound, light. I remember being enveloped in complete, impenetrable darkness. And then I sensed a presence enfolding me and cradling me, whispering quietly to me. The sensation is impossible to describe. I was being held back, firmly but gently, as a mother would a child, eager to slip from her grasp. I felt life and warmth flowing through my veins again. I began to be aware of small sounds and the discomfort of my hip pressing into the cold stone of the tower floor. The Fade contained spirits both benevolent and malicious. The benevolent spirits seldom make themselves known, because they want nothing from mortals, unlike the demons. It was one of these spirits that saved me. Without it, I would be dead. And it has not left me. It is with me, even now, bonded to me. You see, I am supposed to be dead. It is the spirit that is keeping me in this world. And this is not the way of things. Perhaps the spirit did not expect this, but it is weakening gradually. I am living on borrowed time. Yes, that we will.
Oh, hello. Is there something you wanted to talk about? It's nothing. I'm fine. I'm just thinking. I can't get what happened out of my head. I'd been in Lothering for years, and she still thought I was plotting against her. She didn't trust me. Maybe she never did. She loved me when she could use me and control me. And now that she can't, she wants me dead. It hurts to realize that I never really knew her. You are already helping so much by listening to me. I knew she was ruthless. But I didn't know how far she could go. She is self-serving, cruel. She uses people, then discards them. But that's how she survives in the life she leads. What if she's right? What if we're the same? I should just have stayed in the Chantry. You don't understand. I forgot my life as a bard while I was in the cloister. I felt safe. I didn't have to watch my back all the time. That's what made Marjolaine the person she is, don't you see? It ruined her. It will ruin me too. It's already happened. When we killed her, I enjoyed it. Seeing her dead gave me satisfaction. But that is no reason to rejoice over her death. That is what she would do. I don't want that. What we're doing, what we've done, hunted men down, killed them. Part of me loves it. It invigorates me, and this scares me. I feel myself slipping. I admit that I took great pleasure in the intrigue back in Orlais. It was dangerous and chaotic and exciting, but it destroyed my life. I thought the Chantry showed me another path. I thought I was done with this life. Am I wrong? There is this thought that floats into my mind constantly, that I lie when I say the Chantry gave me peace, when in truth it bored me. Here, with you, knowing the freedom of the road and the uncertainty of tomorrow, I feel alive again. I would like to be alone for now. I have many things to consider. Thank you for listening to me.
What are you doing in Haven? There's nothing for you here. No, you do not. I would have been informed if someone was expecting a visitor. You may trade for supplies at the shop if you wish. Then I suggest you and your companions leave.
They are hiding something. 'Tis obvious, is it not?
Ah, quiet insular communities. There's always something nasty going on behind the closed doors. I hope it involves chains. I hope they asked me to join in.
Interesting strategy. Tell me, do you intend to keep going north until it becomes south and attack the Archdemon from the rear? Truly, it would surprise me if my enemy counterattacked by running away and climbing a mountain. And that is more important than the Blight? Why? His army was broken at Ostagar. He is a solitary old man. Why do you fear him? Revenge will not end the Blight. We're wasting effort. I will not simply follow in your shadow as you run from battle. Not anymore. I'm taking command. Defend yourself, Warden. We will settle this. I was wrong. You are strong enough. What now? Lead. I will follow.
So there. Morgan comes over here like, you two idiots. Gotta clean up your mess. Alright, here we are. Haven. Where there is some shit going on.
I wonder. The crows often made sacrifices of blood, and it gave them uncanny abilities.
That is human blood. I just do. I also know that no one can lose that much blood and live.
What? Why are you looking at me like that? Haven is Haven, but I have a secret. Do you want to see? Don't know. It's lucky. I keep it with me. Don't tell anyone, all right?
Creepy. Very creepy.
Who are you? You're not from Haven. We don't get very many visitors. I don't have much, but I suppose you can take a look. What are you doing? That's private! Then you will trade for them, like everyone else.
Delighted. Couldn't we all just get along? No?
Sten is not a name, is it?
Do you always begin conversations this way?
It's your rank, is it not? I've met a few Kunari in Antiva, you know. Not much for conversation, but some of them are quite easy on the eyes.
Those are not Kunari.
No? They are what, then? Very large dwarves with comical accents?
They wear the faces of Kunari, but they are Tal Vashoth, fiends of Seheron. They have abandoned the Kun.
With titles like your own, though. Which makes me curious, what is your name, then?
Sten is enough.
But it is not your name.
It is who I am.
Why are all these random unarmed people attacking me? This is not a good idea, guys. This is like a trap.
We are blessed beyond measure. We are chosen by the Holy and beloved to be her guardians. This sacred duty is given to us alone. Rejoice, my brethren, and prepare your hearts to receive her. Lift up your voices and despair not, for she will raise her faithful servants to glory when her... Ah, welcome. I heard we had a visitor wandering about the village. I trust you've enjoyed your time in Haven so far? What sort of welcome do you expect when you break into our homes and kill one of us? You see, this is why we do not like visitors. They are not like us. They will do us harm if we let them. We don't owe you any explanations for our actions. We have a sacred duty. Failure to protect her would be a greater sin. All will be forgiven.
Who are you? They've sent you to finish it. You don't know how glad I am to see someone who isn't from this village. The leg's not doing so well, and I can't feel my foot.
The leg is wounded, but that will heal in time. The foot may have to come off.
I thought you might say that. But if the foot goes, it goes. There are more important things than an old man's feet. I don't have time to rest now. I'm so close. The urn is just up that mountain. The Arl is sick. Will he live? Politics never did anyone any good. The Arl is a noble soul. But the ashes will surely cure him. Haven lies in the shadow of the mountain that holds the urn. There is an old temple there built to protect it. The door is always locked, but I know what the key is. Irik wears a medallion that opens the temple door. I've seen what he does with it. Yes, that is your key. Take me to the mountainside and I will show you. It is not that far, and will you let me lean on you? For the urn, any pain is worth enduring. Ah, good. Help me up here. I'll try not to slow us down. Here we are. Give me the medallion, and let's see if I remember. Yes, you see, it can be manipulated, just like this. And there, a key to open the way. May have been passed down through the generations, from the first people who built the temple. Now, where does this go? Oh, what I would give to have seen this hall in all its splendor, as it was meant to be. Still, sweep away the ice and the snow, and traces of beauty remain. I'm sorry, what? I was a little distracted, I apologize. These carvings were created just after Andraste's death, and they may reveal things about her life that we do not yet know. I think I need more time to study these statues and carvings. I could not keep up with you with my injuries. I should be safe. I don't think there are any villagers here. Go, I will be all right. Perhaps my destiny was only to lead you to the Urn. Ah, it's my job. Just be careful, that's all I ask. The temple is perilous. I'll be right here if you need me. You're back. Have you reached the Urn?
That was weird. I wonder if that's because I have dialogue tweaks turned off. Maybe I should turn it back on.
An ancient temple, lost to all but a select few. Magnificent.
Glad you
delighted.
Like it. I didn't bring you with me last time, I don't think, so this'll be fun.
Ah!
As you desire.
Cannot push it further. I think I need
This should be good.
As you desire. Of course.
Mafarath, husband of Andraste and her betrayer. What? I went to the Chantry as a child.
Couldn't we all just get along? No.
Another religious figure. Are we to be taught the entire history of Andraste now?
Now that would have a trophy or two.
Stop! You will go no further! You have defiled our temple. You have spilled the blood of the faithful and slaughtered our young. No more! You will tell me now, intruder, why you have done all this. Why have you come here? I am Father Colgrim, leader and guide to the disciples of Andraste. Kill us, and you will face Andraste. She will smell our blood, and the blood of her children on you, and her wrath will be great. She is so much more! She is even more glorious than all the old gods combined! The prophet Andraste has overcome death itself, and has returned to her faithful in a form more radiant than you can imagine. Not even the Tevinter Imperium could hope to slay her now. What hope do you have? They are still within this temple, but why do we need ashes when we serve the risen Andraste in all her glory? You know nothing! Andraste revealed herself to us! We are her chosen! To arms, my brethren! Andraste will grant us victory!
Couldn't we all just get along?
If you were more careful, that wouldn't happen.
creepy time for Dragon Baby. Dragon Baby. Don't mind me. We're not here.
Delighted.
This is not like the rest of the temple. This part is unblemished, untouched.
I bid you welcome, Pilgrim. I am the guardian, the protector of the Urn of Sacred Ashes. I have waited years for this. No one can take the ashes. They belong here. It has been my duty, my life, to protect the urn and prepare the way for the faithful who come to revere Andraste. For years beyond counting have I been here. And shall I remain until my task is done and the Imperium has crumbled into the sea? Ah. Is it not? Then perhaps this is the beginning of the end. No. Our Andraste has gone to the Maker's side. She will not return. The dragon is a fearsome creature, and they must have seen her as an alternative to the absent Maker and his silent Andraste. A true believer would not require audacious displays of power. You have come to honor Andraste, and you shall, if you prove yourself worthy. Still, you must prove yourself worthy. It is not my place to decide your worthiness. The gauntlet does that. If you are found worthy, you will see the urn and be allowed to take a small pinch of the ashes for yourself. If not... Before you go, there is something I must ask. I see that the path that led you here was not easy. There is suffering in your past, your suffering, and the suffering of others. By the time you reached Shiani, she was broken, brutalized. You were too late. Tell me, Pilgrim, did you fail Shiani? Thank you. That is all I wish to know.
Is there any religion that does not thrive upon guilt, like a glutton at his lunch? No, I thought not.
And now the self-flagellation? Oh, that is what comes next in these things, no?
Parshera, leave the past where it falls.
And what of those that follow you? And the Anteven Elf?
Oh, is it my turn now? Hurrah! I'm so excited.
Many have died at your hand, but is there any you regret more than a woman by the name of...
How do you know about that?
I know much. It is allowed to me. The question stands, however. Do you regret?
Yes, the answer is yes, if that's what you wish to know. I do. Now move on.
Demand whatever answers you want, Spirit.
You came to this land as an observer, but you killed a family in a blind rage. Have you failed your people by allowing a Quinari to be seen in that light?
I have never denied that I failed.
And you, Morrigan, Flemeth's daughter, what?
Begone, Spirit. I will not play your games.
I will respect your wishes. The way is open, good luck, and may you find what you seek.
Nosy bastard.
Hey. Who else? It's good to see you, I suppose. Life out there has been good to you, hasn't it? You're respected even among humans. Do you remember us? Where you came from? And what some of us still face every day? What happened? It wasn't really your fault. You were caught in the situation just like the rest of us. You have a great task to complete. I want you to take this. I think you should have it. Seeing you now gives me hope. For all of us.
Ah, this looks like a simple enough puzzle. Let us put our heads together.
I hope you mean that literally, Zevran. Okay. This is gonna be fun.
A path that looks like it's there but is really a trap? I want one.
Okay.
Ah, so there's the trick. Each piece must be made solid in order for one of us to cross.
Yep, and it gets to be you.
And here we are, playing with switches and stepping stones.
You know what, sir?
Mother of mercy! It is real!
We get to walk through the fire butt naked. Butt naked and covered in blood. So that's fun. It's bonding time.
You have been through the trials of the gauntlet. You have walked the path of Andraste, and like her, you have been cleansed. You have proven yourself worthy, pilgrim. Approach the sacred ashes.
I was gonna say, am I allowed to put my clothes back on first? Great.
I stand in awe. Really?
Congratulations. You found a waste bin.
Nice vase. I should get one for my house.
All three of you are terrible, terrible people. And I love you so much. Out of here.
Welcome back. You were gone for quite some time. Well, did you find it?
Is that? There's some dust on. No, that's not dust. Oh, Maker, I'm not worthy to look upon. What was it like coming to the urn, I mean? Tests? Interesting. Very interesting.
Perhaps my research will not seem so much like blasphemy to the Chantry now. We must organize an expedition. There is so much history here, it must be studied. And pilgrims should be allowed to come to the Urn. But the Urn belongs to all the faithful. How can you deny this to them? No, we must share it.
Deny them a corpse? Unthinkable indeed.
And perhaps charge an entrance fee, no?
Yes, share it. Spread the word and more will come under the Chantry's power. Is this not what you want?
I will spread this good news or die trying. I must return home. I have much to do. If you ever find yourself in Denerim, please visit me. I am not a rich man, but I have a small collection of interesting artifacts, and I do owe you a reward for coming to my rescue. I hope to see you soon, my friend.
You return. Might you have news? You have? Wonderful. Let us go at once to Eamon's side and see if the Urn's healing powers live up to their reputation. Calm, brother. You have been deathly ill for a very long time. Do you remember nothing?
Tegan? What are you doing here? Where is Isolde?
I am here, my husband.
And Connor, where is my boy? Where is our son?
He lives, though many others are dead. There is much to tell you, husband.
Dead? Then it was not a dream.
Much has happened since you fell ill, brother. Some of it will not be easy for you to hear.
Then tell me. I wish to hear all of it. This is most troubling. There is much to be done, that is true. But I should first be thankful to those who have done so much. Grey Warden, you have not only saved my life, but kept my family safe as well. I am in your debt. Will you permit me to offer you a reward for your service? Then allow me to declare you and those traveling with you champions of Redcliffe. You will always be a welcome guest within these halls. And for you, Warden, a shield of the same make as those that have been given to our finest knights.
Indeed. We have no way of knowing what Loghain will do once he learns of your recovery.
Loghain instigates a civil war even though the Darkspawn are on our very doorstep. Long I have known him. He is a sensible man. One who never desired power.
I was there when he announced he was taking control of the throne, Eamon. He is mad with ambition, I tell you.
Mad indeed. Mad enough to kill Caelan, to attempt to kill myself and destroy my lands. Whatever happened to him, Loghain must be stopped. What's more, we can scarce afford to fight this war to its bitter end. We have no time to wage a campaign against him. Someone must surrender if Ferelden is to have any chance at fighting the Darkspawn. I will spread word of Loghain's treachery, both here and against the king. But it will be but a claim made without proof. Those claims will give Loghain's allies pause, but we must combine it with a challenge Loghain cannot ignore. We need someone with a stronger claim to the throne than Loghain's daughter, the Queen.
Are you referring to Alistair, brother? Are you certain?
I would not propose such a thing if we had an alternative, but the unthinkable has occurred. Tegan and I have a claim through marriage, but we would seem opportunists no better than Loghain. Alistair's claim is by blood.
And what about me? Does anyone care what I want?
You have a responsibility, Alistair. Without you, Loghain wins. I would have to support him for the sake of Ferelden. Is that what you want?
No, my lord.
I see only one way to proceed.
I will call for a landsmeet, a gathering of all of Ferelden's nobility in the city of Denerim. There, Ferelden can decide who shall rule, one way or another. Then the business of fighting our true foe can begin. What say you to that, my friend? I do not wish to proceed without your blessing. Very well. I will send out the word. It will take some time to recall my forces and organize our allies. I would prefer to wait until that is done before calling the Landsmeet. In the meantime, I suggest you pursue the remainder of the Grey Warden treaties. We will need all the allies we can get if we are to defeat the Darkspawn Horde.
That smell. This is Antivan leather, isn't it? I would know that anywhere.
I don't know how you found it, but thank you.
But I'm not finished admiring them yet. Can you smell that? Like rotting flesh. Just like back in Antiva City. Now, if only you could find me a prostitute or two. A bowl of fish chowder and a corrupt politician. I'd really feel like I was home. And they fit as well. Marvelous! You call?